let's get to our big story for today. Now, the CBI has named Karnataka Development Minister K.J. George for his alleged role in the suicide of former top cop M.K. Ganapati. Apart from the Congress minister, two other senior cops have been named by the probe agency as well. Nevertheless, the Karnataka government continues to stand by their minister. In fact, Chief Minister Siddaramaiah refused to sack the controversial minister, and instead he termed the allegations as a political vendetta campaign. Let's listen in first to what he had to say.
Since it is a old FIR already registered in the police station, and there is no necessity or it warrants Mr. George to resign in this case. The demand made by BJP people is totally politically motivated in order to tarnish the image of Mr. George and also tarnish the image of our government. And they wanted to take political gain out of this.
All right, now just to give you a little bit of a background, charges leveled against K.J. George are on the basis of an interview that Ganapati gave on July 7th last year. Now, an hour before he committed suicide, he told a private Kannada TV channel that K.J. George and two senior police officials, namely Ashit Mohan and Prasad and Pranab Mohanty, would be responsible if anything were to happen to him. Now, despite this, investigations conducted by the Karnataka police gave him a clean chit. And the minister in the eye of the storm remains confident that the charges leveled against him will be quashed. Let's listen in to him defending himself first.
See, this is an old case. A old complaint was filed by Mr. Nehal, the late Ganapati's son, accusing that we are involved in that thing, and his father had given a statement before his death. That magistrate has ordered for an inquiry. When magistrate ordered the inquiry, I resigned my own from the ministry. And the High Court also intervened, and I scored instead of the local police, I could ask the CID to investigate the case under the supervision of DGP, IGP. Meantime, the father and brother of late Mr. Ganapati went to the High Court asking for the CBI inquiry. High Court rejected. Then they went to the Supreme Court. Supreme Court told, I can quote Supreme Court judgment, having considered the entirety of the material before this court, but without expressing any opinion on merits, we direct that investigation be handed over to the CBI. CBI may complete the investigation as far as possible within 3 months from the date of receipt of a copy of the order. The investigation may be supervised by an officer of an appropriate rank. Having regard to the nature of the present case, it will be open to CBI to conduct investigation afresh or in continuation of the investigation already conducted. It will be open to the CBI to ascertain the nature of offence, if any, committed and by whom. This is the CBI, the Supreme Court order. Now the CBI got 3 months' time. Let them investigate. Let them give a report. Then I can comment on the CBI investigation.
Now, while Congress has gone all out to shield K.J. George, claiming political vendetta in his name cropping up in the M.K. Ganapati case, the BJP continues to demand that K.J. George be sacked.
Today, Chief Minister has called us to discuss various parameters on various issues. He has been called. Let us look at it.
Sir, but
it is a politically motivated case. Mr. George is very clean. I think there is no need of any resignation. But I know what opponent political parties plays. If I shall I give you a list of the ministers or BJP ministers who has a case, either here or there.
But you are in power right now, so that's it. And do you are in power right now.
No, I'm telling you. I'm telling you on the people who are in power, I'm going to speak on that.
So do you think that CBI is being misused by the central government?
See, this is full of politics. It is a political era.
The Supreme Court has shammed CID investigation, which gave KJ George clean chit. And therefore, Supreme Court mandated CBI inquiry. And it's an open and shut case. And therefore, this is how Congress is ruling in Karnataka and destroying Karnataka. The way they are, the suicide of a police officer, Ganapati, and where he has alleged and his family has alleged the role of minister and others, and the FIR has been launched, and therefore this is how they are looting left, right and center and harassing people of Karnataka and harassing officers of Karnataka.
No need for our minister to resign, because there is no new evidence, no new issues, no new evidence that has been thrown to light. Nothing is there. So that investigation by CBI also, let's see what they come out with.
So looking at the developments,
CBI used as a political tool? See, now CBI, income tax, even the election commission has become a political tool today by the central government. Everything is a political tool. They are out to harass us. They are out to destroy the opposition. They are out to try to finish off the opposition. And not only the election commission, not only the income tax, not only the CBI. In fact, many media houses also are part of their campaign. But this is a very systematic work being done by Mr. Amit Shah and Mr. Modi to use these agencies to attack and intimidate and defame opposition parties.
Ganapati case is an old case. CID has already given a report, B-report on this issue. And in the same complaint, in continuation of it, they have registered a case and FIR has been filed. And there is nothing to say. It is only an abutment.
All right, for more details on this, let's go across to Srija, who's joining me at this point. Srija, I'm going to come to you for as far as the background of this entire case is concerned in a little bit. But before that, Congress, of course, is staunchly supporting KJ George. Take us through the details of what Chief Minister said when he addressed the media this afternoon.
Definitely, Avni, soon after the CBI took over the case, definitely the going by the FIR, the first accused mentioned in the first information report is KJ George, the Bengaluru Development Minister, followed by Pranam Mohanty, who is in fact the IGP in Lokayukta, and as well as Prasad, who is the ADGP of the Intelligence State. Remember, all these three people have been mentioned in the FIR as far as the CBI investigation into MK Ganapati's suspicious death is concerned. The suicide, as they claim it. Also, soon after that, this news has created ripples in the Karnataka politics. That is exactly when Chief Minister Siddaramaiah came out in the open, backing KJ George, saying that he won't step down, and he because there have been no concrete evidence against him for him to step down as Bengaluru Development Minister. We did, of course, see other cabinet ministers as well. They backed him up. They even backed KJ George, saying that. This was just a vendetta politics. It was just another gimmick by the BJP, in fact, to pull down the Congress, which is ruling here in Karnataka state. And remember that elections is just right around the corner. We have another 6 more months to go, and Karnataka will go into polls coming March. Exactly, that is one of the reasons where at this point in time, both the political parties, the major political parties, Congress, as well as BJP, they are resorting to blame game at this point in time. While the Congress says there are enough number of tainted ministers within the union cabinet as well as here in the BJP. When they haven't resigned, why should a minister cabinet in Siddaramaiah's cabinet should resign is the question that Chief Minister posed. Definitely they did, of course, question the BJP, saying that this is just another a gimmick by the BJP to tarnish the image of the ruling Congress here in Karnataka.
All right, it's being seen as the semi-final before Lok Sabha 2019, the acid test for big ticket reforms like demonetization and GST. Battleground Gujarat is readying for a high stakes battle this December. Party leader Hardik Patel, in fact, told Mirror Now that he will support Congress in Gujarat if they accept his demands. Listen in.
जानते हैं कि अभी सिर्फ डेढ़ महीना रह गया है इलेक्शंस के लिए गुजरात में. अगर हम बीजेपी और कांग्रेस की बात किए जाए, दोनों जो हैं वो अपने अपने सीट्स के लिए लड़ रहे हैं. आपके बारे में अगर बात किया जाए, आप काफी लोगों से, आपके खुद के रैली में काफी लोगों से आप मिल रहे हैं, आपको क्या लगता है कि इस टाइम सेंटिमेंट क्या है लोगों का, वो किन्हें वोट करेंगे? क्योंकि बीजेपी 5 सालों से पावर में आई है, कांग्रेस भी बहुत अच्छे पावर में अपना लाने की कोशिश करी, पर आपको क्या लगता है, आप इतने सारे लोगों से मिल रहे हैं, सेंटिमेंट क्या है अभी लोगों में?
सब लोग यही कहते हैं कि हमें अधिकार चाहिए, किसानों का कर्जा माफी हो, पटेलों को आरक्षण मिले, युवाओं को रोजगार मिले. इसी मुद्दे के आधार पर गांव-गांव हम घूमते हैं, लोगों से मिलते हैं, लोगों का रिस्पॉन्स जानते हैं और वही रिस्पॉन्स हम लोगों के सामने रखते हैं. आने वाले दिनों के अंदर गुजरात की जनता यही चाहती है कि हमें हमारा अधिकार चाहिए, सरकार चाहे कोई भी हो. और भाजपा पिछले 25 सालों से जिस तरह से लोगों को सोच रही है, परेशान कर रही है, इससे जनता के अंदर एक आक्रोश फूटा है.
आप इलेक्शंस लड़ने वाले हैं?
मेरी उम्र नहीं है.
पर आप कोई पार्टी को बैक करेंगे, सपोर्ट करेंगे कोई पार्टी को? हमने ये सुना आप कांग्रेस को सपोर्ट करेंगे, भले आप, क्योंकि आप एलिजिबल नहीं है, आपकी उम्र नहीं है, बट आप कांग्रेस को, हमने ये भी सुना आप कांग्रेस में भी काफी लोगों से, लीडर्स से मिले हैं, अभी राहुल गांधी से भी मिलने वाले हैं, आप सपोर्ट करेंगे कांग्रेस से? क्या आश्वासन क्या दिए आपको?
कांग्रेस हमें समर्थन करेगी तो रिटर्न समर्थन मिलेगा.
क्या आपकी बातचीत क्या हुई कांग्रेस से, क्या बातचीत हुई?
बस 2-3 तारीख को हमारी मुलाकात, उस टाइम बातचीत होगी.
और आप पाटीदार इश्यू के लिए काफी लड़ रहे हैं इतने टाइम से, उनके कोटास के लिए, बीट एजुकेशन हो या जॉब्स में हो, गवर्नमेंट रिजर्वेशन जॉब्स हो, अभी आपकी मांग क्या रहेगी? क्योंकि आप इंडिविजुअल रैलीज आप अभी एड्रेस कर रहे हो ऑल ओवर, तो अभी आपकी, आप कैसे ये करोगे आपकी डिमांड्स मीट हो?
देखो, हमने उन्होंने यही कहा, जिस तरह से आप आरक्षण देने की बात करते हो, उस मुद्दे पर संवैधानिक क्या हो सकता है, संवैधानिक तौर पर आरक्षण कैसे रखा जा सकता है, उसे कोर्ट खारिज नहीं करेगी. तो इस मुद्दे पर अगर कांग्रेस हमें कहेगी तो हम बिल्कुल पब्लिक को कहेंगे कि आपको भाजपा के खिलाफ वोट करना है, और पब्लिक समझदार है, उसको कहाँ वोट करना वो जानते हैं.
और बस सिर्फ आखिरी सवाल, बीजेपी को आप, वो बीजेपी आपको चाहिए, क्योंकि एक इंटरव्यू में मैंने आपका ये पढ़ा है, आपने बोला है कि आप बीजेपी को जिताएंगे नहीं, उसका मतलब ये है कि आप एटलीस्ट कांग्रेस को सपोर्ट करेंगे?
पहली बात मैंने यही कही कि जनता समझदार है, वो भाजपा को वोट नहीं करना चाहती.
और आखिरी चीज, अभी फार्मर्स में अभी करंट सिचुएशन क्राइसिस क्या है? बिकॉज आज आप अमरेली में, खांबा, पूरे आप पूरे यहाँ पे फार्मर्स के यहाँ पे घूमे हैं, विजिट मारा है, क्या एटलीस्ट क्राइसिस क्या है अभी, करंट सिचुएशन क्या है, और आपको क्या चाहिए कि जो भी पावर में आए, कांग्रेस हो या बीजेपी हो, वो क्या जल्द से जल्द ऑन ग्राउंड इम्प्लीमेंट करें?
यहाँ पर किसानों के लिए पानी भेजना जरूरी है, पानी यहाँ नहीं है किसानों के लिए. यहाँ पर किसानों को जो चीज़ उत्पादन होती है उसका दाम सही मिलना चाहिए. किसानों को सही ना सही तौर से जो भी कृषि आयोजित योजना है उनका लाभ देना चाहिए.
All right, let's go across to Disha Shah, who's joining me at this point. Disha, take us through what the mood is like on the ground. We just heard you in conversation with Hardik Patel.
That's right, Amni, at this point in time, what we understand when we spoke to Hardik Patel, who is known as the face of for Patidar community. We definitely went on to say that he is the one who is not going to support BJP for sure. He's not in favor of BJP, considering what he claims is that considering the work the BJP has done in his power, people are really not happy is what he claimed, and he told us on Mirror Now. But when we talk about the mood here, the election fever has already begun here at this point in time. I mean, you know for the fact that the election dates have been declared, which is 9 December and 14 December. The voting will take place in two phases, and the counting will take place on 18th of December. But right now, when we talk about Hardik Patel particularly, we know for the fact that he has started addressing his individual rallies across Gujarat. Today he was in around Bhavnagar in the interiors. He visited the farmers. He saw the plight and the situation out there, which was exactly also questioned to him. And even when we saw the situation on ground, there are basic necessities which has to be implemented, like electricity and water is also not available here for farmers, at least when we talk about. We know for the fact, on the other hand, Congress has also started their rallies in a very big way in Gujarat. Rahul Gandhi has been addressing rallies, and he has been talking what exactly he will implement on ground, right? From making infrastructure better, at least in Gujarat. And for Hardik Patel, we know he has been demanding quotas, especially in reservation for in jobs and even in education, especially for Patidar community. And just for our viewers, only 40% of the state's population considers of Patidars here, the Patels community. So definitely he has been fighting for that. But today, as per the conversation that we had with him, he said that definitely he will look ahead, going ahead to support Congress, but only if they meet his demands of of giving the reservations to Patidar. And he's also going to meet Rahul Gandhi on 2nd or 3rd of November when he's here in South Gujarat conducting one of the very biggest rallies.
All right, Disha, thanks for getting us those details. Let's once again just listen in to Hardik Patel.
जानते हैं कि अभी सिर्फ 1.5 महीना रह गया है इलेक्शंस के लिए गुजरात में. अगर हम बीजेपी और कांग्रेस की बात किए जाए, दोनों जो हैं वो अपने अपने सीट्स के लिए लड़ रहे हैं. आपके बारे में अगर बात किया जाए, आप काफी लोगों से, आपके खुद के रैली में काफी लोगों से आप मिल रहे हैं, आपको क्या लगता है कि इस टाइम सेंटिमेंट क्या है लोगों का, वो किन्हें वोट करेंगे? क्योंकि बीजेपी 5 सालों से पावर में आई है, कांग्रेस भी बहुत अच्छे पावर में अपना लाने की कोशिश करी, पर आपको क्या लगता है, आप इतने सारे लोगों से मिल रहे हैं, सेंटिमेंट क्या है अभी लोगों में?
सब लोग यही कहते हैं कि हमें अधिकार चाहिए, किसानों का कर्जा माफी हो, पटेलों को आरक्षण मिले, युवाओं को रोजगार मिले. इसी मुद्दे के आधार पर गांव-गांव हम घूमते हैं, लोगों से मिलते हैं, लोगों का रिस्पॉन्स जानते हैं, और वही रिस्पॉन्स हम लोगों के सामने रखते हैं. आने वाले दिनों के अंदर गुजरात की जनता यही चाहती है कि हमें हमारा अधिकार चाहिए, सरकार चाहे कोई भी हो. पर भाजपा पिछले 25 सालों से जिस तरह से लोगों को सोच रही है, परेशान कर रही है, इससे जनता के अंदर एक आक्रोश फूटा है.
आप इलेक्शंस लड़ने वाले हैं?
मेरी उम्र नहीं है.
पर आप कोई पार्टी को बैक करेंगे, सपोर्ट करेंगे कोई पार्टी को? हमने ये सुना आप कांग्रेस को सपोर्ट करेंगे, भले आप, क्योंकि आप एलिजिबल नहीं है, आपकी उम्र नहीं है, बट आप कांग्रेस को, हमने ये भी सुना आप कांग्रेस में भी काफी लोगों से, लीडर्स से मिले हैं, अभी राहुल गांधी से भी मिलने वाले हैं, आप सपोर्ट करेंगे कांग्रेस से? क्या आश्वासन क्या दिए आप?
कांग्रेस हमें समर्थन करेगी तो रिटर्न समर्थन मिलेगा.
क्या आपकी बातचीत क्या हुई कांग्रेस से, क्या बातचीत हुई?
बस 2-3 तारीख को हमारी मुलाकात, उस टाइम बातचीत होगी.
और आप पाटीदार इश्यू के लिए काफी लड़ रहे हैं इतने टाइम से, उनके कोटास के लिए, बीट एजुकेशन हो या जॉब्स में हो, गवर्नमेंट रिजर्वेशन जॉब्स हो, अभी आपकी मांग क्या रहेगी? क्योंकि आप इंडिविजुअल रैलीज आप अभी एड्रेस कर रहे हो ऑल ओवर, तो अभी आपकी, आप कैसे ये करोगे आपकी डिमांड्स मीट हो?
देखो, हमने उन्होंने यही कहा, जिस तरह से आप आरक्षण देने की बात करते हो, उस मुद्दे पर संवैधानिक क्या हो सकता है, संवैधानिक तौर पर आरक्षण कैसे रखा जा सकता है, उसे कोर्ट खारिज नहीं करेगी. तो इस मुद्दे पर अगर कांग्रेस हमें कहेगी तो हम बिल्कुल पब्लिक को कहेंगे कि आपको भाजपा के खिलाफ वोट करना है, और पब्लिक समझदार है, उसको कहाँ वोट करना, वो जानते हैं.
और बस सिर्फ आखिरी सवाल, बीजेपी को आप, वो बीजेपी आपको चाहिए? क्योंकि एक इंटरव्यू में मैंने आपका ये पढ़ा है, आपने बोला है कि आप बीजेपी को जिताएंगे नहीं, उसका मतलब ये है कि आप एटलीस्ट कांग्रेस को सपोर्ट करेंगे?
पहली बात मैंने यही कही कि जनता समझदार है, वो भाजपा को वोट नहीं करना चाहते.
और आखिरी चीज, अभी फार्मर्स में अभी करंट सिचुएशन क्राइसिस क्या है? बिकॉज आज आप अमरेली में खंबा पूरे आप पूरे यहाँ पे फार्मर्स के यहाँ पे घूमे हैं, विजिट मारा है, क्या एटलीस्ट क्राइसिस क्या है अभी, करंट सिचुएशन क्या है, और आपको क्या चाहिए कि जो भी पावर में आए, कांग्रेस हो या बीजेपी हो, वो क्या जल्द से जल्द ऑन ग्राउंड इम्प्लीमेंट करें?
यहाँ पर किसानों के लिए पानी भेजना जरूरी है, पानी यहाँ नहीं है किसानों के लिए। यहाँ पर किसानों को जो चीज़ उत्पादन होती है उसका दाम सही मिलना चाहिए, किसानों को सही ना सही तौर से जो भी कृषि आयोजित योजना है उनका लाभ देना चाहिए।
All right, that was Hardik Patel talking exclusively to Mirror Now's Disha Shah, saying that he will support Congress if they accept his demands as far as the elections go, and also demanding quotas for patidars in jobs and education, making basic needs available for farmers. Those are some of the demands put forth by Hardik Patel. All right, but moving on now, taking note of all the glaring security lapses at schools, the Gurugram District Administration has recommended police action against 135 private schools. This after a security assessment drive was conducted by the District Administration. Now, these schools have been instructed to submit a compliance report within 15 days. Mirror Now's Apurva Sridhar spoke to the Deputy Commissioner of Gurugram to understand what their investigations actually unearthed. Listen in.
We've given notices under Section 144 CRPC to all schools after these guidelines were issued by state government, and ample time has been given, reminders have been given. Schools which have not still submitted their self-certification regarding safety and security of children in their school, this action has been proposed against them.
What are the various pointers, as you were pointing out as well, under which you can take action? Especially, do you think that since derecognition is a very extreme step, it actually involves a lot of things, parents are also worried, do you think that there is anything in between derecognition and taking action against the school in terms of them flouting rules?
See, the law provides three type of actions. Number one is derecognizing the school. Second one is taking over management of the school. And the third one, which we've used in this case. So whatever law provided us, we've used it. And I believe schools which were given ample time to respond, still they have not responded, are bound to be liable for action under the law.
All right, let's in fact go across to Apurva, who's joining me at this point. Apurva, this is something that's quite important, because naming 135 schools, asking for a report, is something that we've also been talking about. Schools need to be held accountable as far as safety and security of children is concerned. What next? Now, within 15 days, these schools have to now file a report.
That's right, Avni. The district administration of Gurugram has now recommended police action against 135 private schools in Gurugram because they failed to submit their self-declaration on how safe the school is for the children. And this, remember, the entire case actually came to light after Pradyuman's murder. And that had opened an entire host of issues regarding safety and security. And after which the state government's education department had issued a notice to all the schools to comply with the safety guidelines and submit their self-safety certificate to the administration. And these are the 135 schools that did not submit or declare their safety certificate, following which the Gurugram District Administration has taken action and said that within the next 15 days, if these schools do not submit their compliance report, action will be taken, and has also sent a letter to the local police saying that action can be taken against these schools under Section 188 of the IPC, which is disobedience of a order there passed by the public servant. Now, the penalty under Section 188 of the IPC is a simple imprisonment for a month or a fine of 200 rupees. And in more serious cases, if it is endangering a life, it goes up to 6 months of imprisonment and a fine of 1,000 rupees or both. So that is the kind of action that has been taken. But more importantly, the question that we put forward is this going to be a deterrent? Is this going to be something that will be looked at very closely by the schools? Will that ever serve as a deterrent? To which we get a reply saying that this is going to be a very big deterrent there, because it is a very big step taken in terms of making sure that the schools comply to the safety audits that will be taking place, to the safety measures that they need to put in place in order to ensure that the kids are school and safe.
All right. Thanks, Apoorva, for getting us all those details. All right. With that, it's a wrap on this edition of The Big Story. Thanks so much for watching.